Hello everyone, I am here with new topics, volcanoes and plate tectonics. Okay, in this topic we are talking about volcanic and plate tectonic theory. Okay, then we start first global distribution of volcanoes. Okay, since the upper part of the earth are solid, everybody know about earth, upper part of earth is solid, and special condition are necessary to magma. These special condition do not exist everywhere beneath the surface, and thus volcanism does not occur everywhere. Okay, if we look at the global surface distribution of the volcanoes, we see that the volcanoes occur at the four principal setting. Volcanoes occur at four principal setting. Okay, and first principle is along divergent plate tectonic. Such oceanic ridge are spreading center. Oceanic ridge are spreading in the center. And second, in area of continental extension that may become divergent plate boundaries in the future. Okay, second part is in area of continental extension, continents jo hai wo extends karta hai, that may become divergent plate boundaries in the future. And third, along converging plate boundaries where subduction is occurring, okay. And in areas called hot spring that are usually located in the interior of the earth crust. Okay, and plate away from the margin. This is the all world waveform, and this part is our Hamara Pyar Bharat, India. Okay, this is our India map, and this is North America, South America, Africa, India, Australia, China, Rus. Okay, this is our continent. And now talking about diverging plate margin. Active volcanism is currently taking place along all of oceanic ridge. Active volcano is occurring, taking place all of the oceanic ridge. But most of the volcanism is submarine volcanism and was not generally pose a threat. Okay, of humans. One of the only place where an oceanic ridge reaches above sea level. One of the only place where the oceanic ridge reaches above the sea level is at Iceland. Iceland pe ke paas ek aisa jagah hai jahan oceanic ridge reaches above the sea level along the mid Atlantic Ocean. Okay, and and here most of the explosive and we are talking next about area of continental extension. This is the area. Okay, and and this is equator, Gulf of Aden, Arabian Plate, Red Sea near to the Aden Plate, and this is Eurasian Plate, this is a Persian Gulf, and this is African Plate. Okay, and plate boundaries and East African Rift and volcanoes. Okay. And now talking about area of continental extension. Volcanoes also occur in continental area. Volcanism also occur in continental area that are undergoing episode of extensional deformation. A classic example of East African Rift Valley, where African plate is being split. And the extension deformation occur deformation occur because of the okay. And and plate boundaries, and this is equator and Gulf of Aden, and this is African plate, and this and we are talking about the converging plate margin. Okay, all around the Pacific Ocean, this zone is offering refer to the Pacific ring of fire. We can see here this shape. This is a ring of fire. We can say ring of fire. Okay. And this shape is a Pacific ring of fire, where most of the world most active and most dangerous volcano occur. The ridge of fire occur because most of the margin and the Pacific Ocean coincide with converging margin along which subduction is occurring. Okay. And the convergent boundary along the coast of South America, Central America, Mexico, okay, and this is regulated formation of continental volcanic activity and these, okay, and this island west of the Alaska, and Karchakata Arc, Japan, Philippines, and the island and Marinas Island, New Zealand, Indonesian Island, where along the northern and the western margin of the Pacific Ocean. Okay, zone of the where oceanic lithosphere is being subducted, beneath oceanic lithosphere. This is called Ireland Arc. And as discussed previously, most of the magma generated as a result of subduction of andesitic magmas, and thus volcanoes in these convergent margin area is predominantly andesitic volcanoes. Okay, but through a complex process known as magmatic differentiation, andesitic magmas can change the rheolithic magma. These rheolithic mechanism volcanism is also common on this area. Okay, and because of magma are often gas rich and have been relatively high viscosity, and eruption on this area tends to violent and with common subduction volcanoes and plain eruption. Volcanic landform tends to be cinder prone. Volcanic landform tends to the cinder cone, stratovolcanoes and volcanic domes and calderas. Okay, response period between eruption tends to hundreds of thousands of years, thus giving people living near the volcanoes false sense of security. Hot spreading, and we are talking about what is hot spreading. Volcanics also occur in area that are not associated with the plate boundaries in the interior of the plate. Volcanoes also occur in area which are not achieved with the plate boundaries in the interior of the plate. These are most commonly associated with the hot spring. Hot spring appear to the hot spring appear to appear to result from plumes of the hot mantle material upwelling toward the surface. Hot mantle material upwelling toward the surface. Okay, toward the surface, independent of the convection cells through to cause plate motion. Okay, hot springs tend to be fixed in position. Hot spot tends to be fixed in the position with the plate moving over the top. As rising plumes mantle move upward, begin to melt, produce magma. These magma then rises to surface productivity volcano. But a plate carrying volcanoes seizes a new volcano from the position now over the hot spring. This tends to produce chains of volcano of seamounts island that have eroded below sea level. Volcanoes resulting from hot spots. Volcanism resulting from hot spots occur in both Atlantic Ocean but are more evident on the sea floor of the Pacific Ocean. The plate here moves at higher velocity. Okay. Earthquake, and we are talking about earthquake. Earthquake occur when energy stored in elasticity, a strand rock is suddenly released. You know, earthquake. Earthquake occur when energy stored in the elastically a strand rock is suddenly released. This release of energy causes instant ground shaking in the area near the source of the earthquake and send wave elastic energy called seismic wave throughout the earth. An earthquake can be generated by bomb blasts. Okay, volcanic eruption suddenly slippage along fault, seismic wave generated by earthquake are invaluable for studying the interior of the earth. Okay, and originally all points, this is fault, this is final, this is alignment of point after earthquake. Origin of earthquake. Now we are discussing about origin of earthquake. Most natural earthquake most natural earthquakes are caused due to origin. Okay, most natural earthquakes are caused by sudden slippage along the fault zone. The elastic rebound theory suggests that if slippage along a fault is hindered such that elastic strain energy build up in a deforming rock by either side of the fault. When the slippage does occur, the energy release cause earthquake, suggesting that the energy stored in bending the rock was suddenly released during the earthquake. What causes the rock to break? Types of stress: compressional, tensional, and shear. shear, types of stress. What causes the rock break? Compress, more compress on rock, tensional stress and shears. Okay. And we are talking about world distribution of earthquake. Okay. Most distribution of earthquake most occur along tectonic plates boundary, and some occur far from plate edge. The main area around the Pacific Ocean, the circum-Pacific belt is major site of large earthquake. Mediterranean Sea area through Iran and on the Himalayan. Okay. And Asia, the most occur along tectonic plate boundaries, and some occur far from plate as the main region. The main area of the plate tectonic boundaries are around the Pacific Ocean ke around hota hai. Circum-Pacific belt is major site of the larger earthquake. Do you know? Around the Pacific Ocean, circum-Pacific belt is major site of the largest earthquake. Okay. And Mediterranean Sea area through Iran and on the Himalayan. Okay, this is our second. And third, Asia, Indonesia, Himalayan region, also a distribution of earthquake. And Asia is three main Himalayan region and Indonesian. And fourth is Mid-Ocean also are facing an earthquake. The disruption. Okay, the distribution of earthquake is referred to as a seismicity. The most earthquake occur along relatively narrow belt that coincide with the plate boundary. This makes sense since plate boundaries are zone along which lithosphere plate. Earthquake along these zone can be divided into shallow focus earthquake that have focal depth less than about 70 kilometer, and deep focus earthquake that have been depth between 75 to 700 kilometer. This is a deep focal depth of earthquake, and the shallow focus earthquake have focal depth less than 70 kilometer. Okay, and this is a circum-Pacific region. This is all earthquake area. This is red part is a earthquake region. Earthquake along this zone can be divided into shallow focus earthquake. Focal depth less than about 70 kilometer is called earthquake. Deep focus earthquake more than 75 up to 700 kilometer. Earthquake at diverging plate boundaries. Diverging plate boundaries are zone where two plates move away from each other. One plate moving this direction, other moving is this direction. Okay, this is called diverging plate boundaries. Zone, two plates move away from each other. Okay, and such as a oceanic ridge. In such area of lithosphere in a state of tensional stress and thus normal fault, this earthquake that such boundaries so normal fault motion and tend to shallow earthquake focal depth less than about 20 kilometer. Okay, such shallow focal length and lithosphere, and this slide is there. Earthquake at transform fault boundaries, and we can also think about earthquake at transform fault boundary. We also see divergent boundaries of possible for the earthquake and earthquake at transform fault boundary. Transform fault, do you know what is transform fault? Transform fault boundaries are the plate boundaries where lithosphere plates slide past one another in horizontal direction. Lithosphere plate slide past one another in horizontal direction. Okay, this is horizontal direction. Okay, this is horizontal direction. This is vertical direction. And we know about detail lithosphere plate slides past one another in horizontal direction, horizontal fashion. The San Andreas Fault of California is one of the major transform fault boundaries known as earthquake transform boundary. California San Andreas Fault of California is the one of the longer fault transform fault boundary in the earthquake of the along these boundary along a strike slip motion fault and the focus earthquake with depth usually less than 50 kilometer. Earthquake at converging plate boundaries. Convergent plate boundaries are boundaries where two plates run into each other. Convergent. Thus, they tend to the zone where compressional stress are active, and thus reverse fault are or thrust fault are common. There are two types of converging plate boundaries. Subduction boundaries, where oceanic lithosphere is pushed beneath either oceanic nor continental lithosphere. Second, collision boundaries, where two plates with continental lithosphere collide. Collision boundaries, where two plates with continental lithosphere collides. Subduction boundaries. Subduction boundaries. A subduction boundary called oceanic lithosphere is pushed down into the mantle where two plates converge at an oceanic trench. Because the subducted lithosphere is cold, it remains brittle as it descends and thus can be fractured under the compressional stress. When it fracture, it generates earthquake that define a zone of earthquake with increasing focal depth beneath the increasing plate. This zone of earthquake is called the baniogic zone. This zone of earthquake is called baniogic zone. Focal default of earthquake is baniogic zone can be reached down to 700 kilometer. Okay, and transform fault is horizontally move away, and oceanic ridge and oceanic trench. Oceanic ridge means two body go away, and oceanic trench are two colliding to each other, and oceanic lithosphere and asthenosphere and earthquake fault mesozoic zone. Okay, and collision boundaries. A collision boundaries, two plates of continental lithosphere collide, resulting in the belt and earthquake occur due to the thrust faulting. Earthquake occur due to the thrust faulting. Okay. This is all about volcanoes and plate tectonic. Okay. And this is a hot spring, and earthquake. We also know earthquake occur energy stored in the elastic strand. Rocky suddenly release, and this release of energy cause extends ground shaking in the area where near the source of the earthquake and sent wave elastic energy with seismic wave throughout the earth. An earthquake called generated by bomb blast and volcanic eruption. This is all about earthquake. And anybody like this video, you can like and comment if you are wanting more video on other geographic topic of UPSC, BPSC and UPSC and other syllabus covering. Okay, thank you.